In my previous video, I showed you how to make a battery out of a potato. The truth, however, is that the potato doesn't make the electricity. The copper and the zinc do, and all you really need is an electrolyte between them. To make a penny battery, you're going to need zinc washers, copper pennies, a small section of cardboard, electrical tape, a small glass, some white vinegar, and a multimeter would be great if you happen to have one. Step one is to pour some vinegar into a small glass. Then, take your piece of cardboard and trace the washers. You're going to need several of these, so trace it a few times and then cut them out. Now, put the cardboard circles into your glass of vinegar and stir them up a bit. These need to soak for at least 2 minutes. The aluminum foil strip is optional, but it will make it easier to check the voltage. Take a zinc washer and then blot dry one of our cardboard circles, placing it on top of the washer. Then, add one of our pennies. Testing the first cell with a multimeter, I got 0.8 volts. That's incredible! To make it even more powerful, let's add two more cells consisting of another zinc washer, cardboard circle, and penny stacked on top. Now it measures 3.4 volts. I'm super impressed. To keep it all together, I wrapped our penny battery with a couple of strips of electrical tape. Then, I gently inserted our blue LED from the potato video, and it lights right up. And that's how you make a potato battery without the potato. And amazingly, 24 hours later, it's still going strong, and I can't help but wonder, how long will this thing last? We'll be right back.